Hey everybody, and welcome to the next chapter, Boolean Indexing Single Conditions. In the last few videos, we focused our efforts on selecting subsets of data based on either the label or integer location of values in the index or columns. We actually did not look at the data itself. We ignored it completely. So in this video, we will focus on the series and data frame values, which is the data, and not on the row or column labels or integer location. So we're gonna actually care about our data in this video. We're gonna make selections based on our data. So to do this, we're gonna do something called Boolean indexing, sometimes referred to as Boolean selection. And this is a two-step process. So the first step involves creating a filter of true or false values, the same length as the data frame. And then we're going to pass this filter to one of the indexers, either just the brackets or the loc indexer. Okay, so let's see some examples of what we will be able to accomplish in just plain English. So for instance, we'll be able to find all the mail riders in a data frame. So assuming we're using the bikes data frame, we'll be able to find all the rides with a duration longer than 2 hours. We could find all the rides that took place between March and June of 2015. Or we could do something even more specific, like find the rides with a duration longer than 2 hours by females when the temperature was higher than 90 degrees. So Boolean selection will be able to answer all of these queries. And query is a term that is used to refer to these sorts of questions. All right. So the way it works, another way of saying this is that all these queries have some logical condition. The condition is either true or false, which means every row is either going to be kept or discarded. So for instance, let's say we're doing a Boolean selection, and we're trying to find all the rows that have a trip duration greater than 1,000. So what happens here is we're going to go one by one down the trip duration column and, you know, do a comparison between that number and 1,000. And if it is greater than 1,000, then we're going to keep it. If it is not, we're going to discard it. So I'm going to show you the syntax to make this happen. So let's scoot down here, and we're going to use one of these comparison operators to make a Boolean series to create the condition. All right, so let's go ahead and do exactly what we had proposed, which was find all the rides that had a trip duration greater than 1,000. So here's the trip duration series. So I went ahead and selected that as a series. And now I'm going to make a comparison versus the number 1,000. So let's just say I want to compare the trip duration column against the number 1,000. So I'm going to use this greater than operator. So what pandas does, and this is very nice, it will actually go through one by one. It'll iterate through all the values and it will return either true or false. So this is called a vectorized operation. And the term vectorized means, you know, without an explicit writing of a for loop, you will be able to, write one command that will do many, that same command over a sequence of values. So this greater than 1,000 was applied to every single value in the trip duration column. Okay, so that is step one. We have a Boolean series. So this is a series of Boolean values, true or false. And, you know, it's the same length as the data frame. It has the same number of rows. Every single row is either true or false. And now we're going to use this Boolean series to select just the rows that are true. So we're going to select row with label 2, you know, with label 8 and 10 and so forth. So let's go ahead and assign this series to a variable name. So I like to use the variable name filt. It's just short for filter. So I'm just creating a filter here, and let's output the head. All right. And then the last step, there's only two steps, is to place this filter inside the brackets. So this is going to appear very weird because I just told you the brackets were primarily used for selecting columns, but they have an alternative use. So let me go ahead and make the selection. And let me verify that trip duration is indeed greater than 1,000. So that looks good. I can append the head method here to shorten the output. So back to the just the brackets. So we first learned that you could either put a string in here or a list of strings. Well, you can also pass in a Boolean series. So, and that will select rows. So this is fairly confusing if you are first seeing this in pandas. Because at first these brackets selected columns, and now we're saying this is able to select rows if you give it a Boolean series. So depending on what is passed in these brackets, pandas will decide what you want to do. So there's different paths that pandas takes based on what you pass it within these brackets. So this is called operator overloading. So this these square brackets, these are overloaded. There's many things you can do with them based on the input. So it's potentially can be confusing because you're using the same syntax to do completely different things. But this is how you do Boolean selection, and I'm fine with teaching this method. It's perfectly good and is what is normally used. All right. So this correctly filtered for just the rows that had a trip duration greater than 1,000. Yes, it's good to manually verify. Of course, that's what this is saying. Just manually verify that indeed all the rows that you can see are greater than 1,000. And yeah, so you can do this in one line of code. So go back up here. I'm just gonna go ahead and copy this. So it's possible to do Boolean selection in a single line. So you could do this. So you could put the filter directly inside the brackets without first assigning it to a variable. So you see this expression in here. That creates the filter. So this is syntactically correct, and it works just the same. It gets me just the rows where trip duration is greater than 1,000. The reason I don't like teaching this is that it puts a lot of a lot of code in one line, and it's kind of confusing to see bikes and then bikes again. So for me, I like separating out the filter and assigning it to its own variable and then placing that variable within the brackets. So, but it is possible to do this in one line, this is how it's done. All right, so let's just look at one more Boolean selection. So there's an events column. Let me go back up here, go all the way to the right. There's an events column over here, and this is just the weather events. So let's select all the rows where there was cloudy weather. So let's get the events column, and to test equality, use two equal signs. So this is going to go through every value in the events column and test it against this string cloudy. Let's go ahead and execute this, and you can see that, okay, we have some cloudy over here. So it looks like it's executed correctly. And then we can assign that to a variable filt, and then we can pass it into the bracket. So I'm just going to make an assignment statement and pass that Boolean series right here. So this should only return events that are cloudy. Okay, that looks that's good. So this is a single condition. All right, and that's what we did in this notebook. In the next notebook, we will do multiple conditions. So that wraps it up for Boolean indexing single conditions. See you in the next one.